Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Today, Ruud Scheerder and I will talk about circular textile. And we would first like to get acquainted. So we will first start with a Mentimeter. But maybe first, I'm Mireille Rijmen from Rijkswaterstaat. I'm working for the Ministry for infrastructure and the environment, I say, because the environment is important. And this is Ruud. He will introduce himself.
Ruud Scheerder, self-employed, and I'm preparing and executing European tenders for workwear for public organizations. Isn't it working? Okay.
So I will just continue for the moment to let you know that we're going to use the Mentimeter, and for this purpose you can use the QR code. We all use the QR code nowadays for several purposes. Or you just go to menti.com and there you can press the code 17589717. So then we can make it interactive, because there are also people who are not in the room right now, but they are following it on a stream, and then it's possible to get some input from the other audience as well. So that's interesting. Is it working right now, Ruud?
I hope. Test. No, it isn't working.
So okay. Maybe the technician can help him further on, and I will just continue. Luckily, I start.
Yeah.
So, welcome everybody. I thought it would be nice to get to know each other. So, first, I would like to ask you to tell us where you're from. We can come from different places all over the world, but we do have one common goal. At least we want to enjoy the nature and the resources of Earth. So I think it's very nice to see that this conference is also being watched from people by people from other countries. That's very interesting, because I didn't expect people from Denmark to watch, but welcome Denmark, and yes, also from France. Very nice. So. Are there people from abroad here? Oh, there are also a few people from here, from abroad. So, the next slide is just how do you feel? So just give me a kind of emotion. I want to know if you're inspired or you're happy or you're thinking, oh, it's sunny today. Just give us a... Let us know what is going on inside you, and hopefully we can make the day better even.
Curious.
Yeah. Ah, you have a mic.
I have an old school mic.
Okay. Ah, there's also a smiley there. That's kind of nice. So, good. All kind of positive vibes here around here. Now I would like to know if you have a certain role. I hope I have every role there, but probably not. The first one is a buyer, because we want to have people here who are interested in purchasing professional textile, and a sustainability officer is in the room. Yes, and I think we have some policymakers somewhere.
No policymakers?
No policymakers, that's unfortunate. Today they could learn a lot. But maybe they are online, and even if it's not possible to see the stream right now, you can still see it later. So, yes, there is one. Okay, and also a lot of others. Yeah, I probably didn't describe it completely complete, but I'm happy to see that there are really a broad range of different roles here in this room, because we all need each other. As Mariska said, it's very important to collect. So the recyclers are also important to sort and to have the right quality. And also the product designers are quite important in the circular economy. So, then we almost start to the main topic, because I hope you After this this presentation, you know how to purchase circular textiles, but if you don't know it yet, you're in the right place. And if you do know it, you can help the other people around us, asking, helping them with certain questions. So I hope you all stay, even though you fill in, yes, I know it. Okay. So there are some people doubting. Most of the people are a bit doubting. They know something.
Okay.
So
that's
Ruud,
good. That's good.
That's you can
useful.
You're very useful. So we will start with the presentation. So I'm just looking at the technicians if they can switch. Yes. Okay. Thank you. So now we're starting to the presentation, and I think we can skip this slide because it's double.
I think.
Yes. So I just wanted to say something about the policy we have in the Netherlands on circular textile. We have a lot of ambitious goals. And as you see, in 2025, we want to have 25 of recycled content or sustainable material in new textile. So that's really about circularity. That's not about just recycling. Although recycling in itself is also good, but it's we really strive to use the material as long as possible. So in the same functionality, you have more chance of using it again and again and closing the loop really well. And also, we also want to make sure that people reuse things. So if you can use your product as long as possible and to fully enjoy the material and the product for a long time and take care of the product, we really get a very low environmental impact. So we hope everybody will be stimulated to reuse and to share and to make it possible that we can do a lot more with less material. I'm not going all the way to explain everything that we have, but I also implemented the link so that people from abroad can read our program in English. But we really hope that we can manage with the other policymakers in Europe to come to a common European ambition and to come to a common European policy, because it's really important to reach these ambitions, because we really have an important goal: close all the loops as far as possible, because we want to enjoy our planet and we want to enjoy the resources for us and our children. So I have one more question, because if we want to attain these goals and know where we are, it's very important to monitor. Previously, for the consumer goods, for the consumer textiles, we have done a mass balance to see what is happening, what is going on, how much textile is in the waste still, and how much is already recycled, how much is exported, because it's very important. If you want to see if your policy is working, you have to monitor. So we really would like to ask all the companies who are active in the professional textile market to address Marijn van der Maasen. She's probably online if she's not here. I don't see her, but she might pop up in the chat online. Then you can contact her, because we are now busy in the professional textile market to make the same kind of mass balance. And it's very important to have good data, also to see how far are we and what do we still need to do to achieve the goals that we have set.
Well, then I will take over.
Yeah, you want to keep it?
I will keep it. I'm going to tell something about the NTA 8195, the Dutch standard for circular textile, and how I use it in my project. But first, why did we need a standard like the NTA? Well, I think it's a real benefit we now can speak the same language, government to suppliers, because In the past, it was really different. And we do have uniform terms and definitions. In the past, my definition of circular textile was, I think, really different than the definition from Rosemary or someone else in the audience. But now we have one definition. And we can avoid greenwashing because there are requirements and on circular textile. So I think it's a major step that we have such a standard in the Netherlands. Well, what is it? It describes the requirements, defines requirements on circular textile, and it aims to be the standard for the Dutch circular textile industry. Well, when I use it, first, the preparation phase of the European tender. I think the most important question is, what is the need of the organization? Can we fulfill the need with off-the-shelf products or custom-made products? Because the strategy I use is really different when I go on a tender custom-made workwear for my clients. And the influence on custom-made is much bigger than off-the-shelf products. Because I can define requirements on circular design, for example. And I can define requirements for the input flow in the product. And for off-the-shelf products, I am depending on what's available on the market for so far. When I use, when I have a project for the off-the-shelf products, I use a growth model, a step-by-step approach to reach circular products at the end of the contract, within a few years. I define a step-by-step approach. And my advice is, use such a model. Well, you can use the awarding criteria, the design for circularity topic of the agreement. You can use it for the custom-made products, as I said. You can ask which percentage of products can be used in other products. The design of the four categories: the design for recycling, design for remanufacturing, repair or reuse, and you can ask it and award it in your tender. But the strategy has to be familiar which collecting process will be defined contractually, and which recycling option or end-of-life option is defined. Well, using the NTA for input flows, we have four categories: the post-consumer material, category A, post-production material, category B, production waste, or the open-loop solution. You can use it two ways. You can set requirements. For example, the T-shirt contains 50-40% of category D1 PET bottles. Or if you are more ambitious, you can set awarding criteria for several products and bring the awarding criteria in line with the objectives of the organization. For example, if your organization wants to reduce textile waste, you will score post-consumer material in the products better than open-loop solution. Then we have the product information and the claims. When suppliers offer the circular textile products, or the products which contain circular material, they need to deliver information, and the claim has to be proven. So I recommend an external audit for it, because certification of the products, we can see that the products contain the material they offer. So they have to prove it and conform ISO 14021. Well, I'm monitoring during the contract. I think in my contracts, the contracts I write, I have a yearly obligation of increasing circular products or the percentage of recycled material in the products. That's a choice you can make. Depends on the strategy you execute it. And there's external audit for the collecting and recycling process. I want to know what is collected, what is recycled yearly. And like I said earlier, the input flows, for example, GRS certificate or another certificate. So yearly verifying all the progress.
So now I will ask the technicians to move again to the Mentimeter because we have some questions for you. Here there is the picnic table, and we were wondering if you know after this story in which category of circular textiles this product falls. So if you again, take the Mentimeter and use the code 17589717, then you can enter your answer. And I can see that the answers are a bit...
Yeah.
a bit... okay. Well, Ruud can... I think Ruud knows in which category it falls.
Wow. I think it's post-consumer open loop.
It is an open loop product, but it's not a textile at all.
Nope.
So this product is becoming it, this pro- the textiles have been recycled, but they're going into another sector. So they're concerning the NTA. It's not circular textile. It's recycled content, but the benches and the tables are not considered as textile materials when they are used as a table or a bench. So the answer, the right answer should be none. And I can see one third of the audience understood the question. There was a bit of a catch, but I just want to know if you're still all awake.
I'm going home.
no, stay here. And then the next, you have the clicker or do I have it? Oh, sorry. The next, well, this very special jacket from the Enschede Textielstad. You can also see it in the audience. Hanneke, just stand up. You can see it, huh?
Wow, turn around.
A very nice jacket. And I would like to know what kind of product, what kind of category does it fall? Is it A1, post-consumer material? B1, post-production material? Is it A1 post-consumer, but also C1 production waste? Or is it A1 post-consumer, but also D1 open loop? So now we can really find out who are the textile specialists here in the room. I can see that it's good that we have these questions, then we can verify a little bit. And it's also not completely fair because maybe you don't know this typical material from Enschede Textielstad.
Tell us.
You know, okay.
Sorry.
No. Otherwise, I thought you can tell us the answer. So what I would like to say is that the right question, does it pop up if or not? Okay. The right question is also open loop. So there is some open loop in it because it's very difficult to make textiles only of recycled material, but it's still a very high recycled content. So here, this is my dress, and next to me is Han from, from Wow Closet. I'll look at wowcloset.nl. So what are our dresses? Is it really not circular? Because it looks quite new, huh? It's kind of wow effect. It's not only the dress, it's also the bag, I should say. Huh? So, what do you think? Well, interesting. I think I see the people are still doubting or filling in the correct answer. The right answer is A4, post-consumer material reuse, because WOW Closet is a platform where you do not buy clothes, but you just lend them. So you have a kind of, you just have a subscription, like a library, and then you can use the products and just bring them back and have a huge choice of clothes and accessories. So yes, the next one. So this is about WOW Closet. So if you're interested, just have a look, because I thought they really achieved the wow factor. I'm really happy with this. And the next one is questions. It says no questions from the audience, but if you want, I don't know how much time there is. That's for the technicians to say. No, I don't know if there's still time for questions. So maybe there is.
I think there is.
Yes,
I think there is.
Okay, you can just type your question if you're not here in the room, but if you're here in the audience, you can just say the question, but I have to repeat it for the people online. So, any questions?
We've got some questions online.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, please do. Ah, that's an interesting question. Sustainable material is more broad than just focusing on the material and on the environment. We think sustainable material is also has to do with the social criteria. We think it's also important to make sure that you're not only looking take care for the environment, but also for the people. So also the working standards is important, and also the quality of life, living wage. So the sustainability is really a container. Definitions. Thank you, Ruud. It's a container definition, and I agree we should make more statements and explain better what we mean with this. But we will work on this. So I think not today, but in a few days, we will fill in the NTA questions. We have frequently asked questions for people who want to know more about the NTA. It's on the NEN website. And we will also describe a little bit more about sustainability, because it's a really important issue. And it's not one issue things, because there are so many important factors that we need to take care of.
Okay.
Oh yes, if there are questions also in the room.
No questions?
Oh. Ah, okay. there's a mic. That's good. Then I don't need to repeat it.
There's an international report called the ECAP.
Mm-hmm.
I think you know it. And they said the most favorable route to discarded clothing is reuse. But when I look at reuse, it's only 10%. So I wonder why the ambition for reuse is lower than the rest.
Well, in the NTA, reuse isn't 10%.
No, he's talking about the policy.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, the policy of the government.
Because I think we have tried to set standards that we think we can achieve. Of course, it would be better if it would be higher.
Yeah.
But this is really also a mentality change. Yeah? And we know that we want to go fast, but it's quite difficult actually to really change.
Yeah.
Not having products anymore, but just sharing and not buying each time. Each time that we go on the street, we feel the urge to maybe to buy new shoes or new clothes or new things. So there is an ambition to do this more, of course, but we also look what is feasible. And another thing is that it's also quite difficult to monitor, because there are many platforms. Luckily, it is stimulated, Vinted, and there are also the WOW Closet and Lena. There are a lot of people trying to change the way we use materials, that we do not own it, but we just share it. But it's a long way to change the people's behaviors. And so
that's why there's a discrepancy between the European and the NTA.
No, the reuse is one of the strategies in the NTA.
Okay, because they say it's the most favorable.
Yes, but the most favorable is not always the easiest. So we try to set goals that we might attain and also measure. So that's the reason why. Okay. But you're right, using more intensively our products, that's the way forward.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
I agree. I want to say one thing more, and it's for Dutch procurers. The MRA has published a guide for the sustainable procurement of workwear based on the NTA. So you can download it for free on the website of the MRA.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes, and just to be clear, the policy I presented, it's the Dutch policy, huh? We hope. It becomes one European policy. We all go in the same direction, but it's still our Dutch policy on circular textiles. Sorry, there's one more question.
Question online?
One more question online. Yes.
Yes.
And it's from Julia Kramer. Her question is 25% post-consumer recycled includes for polyester as well as recycled polyester from PET bottles.
When we have the PET bottles, it's from the open loop, so it's D1. So yeah. As soon as you take material from outside the textile loop and you want to use it for textiles, it's still regarded as it's still awarded as in the scheme, but it's D1. I think Ruud also mentioned an example like that.
It's category D1, PET bottles.
And maybe interesting for you to see, there are also other products. You probably found these type of products also on the... And this is actually a Rijkswaterstaat bag for the car drivers, that they don't drop their plastics everywhere. It's developed by children, so they know how to design and how to think of ideas, how to keep plastic out of the environment and hang this on the back seat. And they put all the litter in. And then this is made from workwear, and it's made by Sheltershoot. So it's a social corporation.
Sheltershoot Foundation. Yeah. Okay.
Well, we hope next time we are here, we hope to see much more products.
So.
There's still another question, I see.
Yes. Yeah?
So we should just continue. It's part of,
yeah.
So it's A2, I think. You have to put on the table.
Well, design for repair.
Oh, it's not in this Mentimeter, sorry. It's in the other presentation.
Okay. It is a part of the NTA, design for repair.
Yes.
Further questions?
Any more questions? If you still find a question, you can ask us later when we are here, or just try to find us online. But also, it's also possible to still fill in your question, because I've left the Mentimeter open for the next 10 days. So if there a question pops up, we can still answer them later, just online. So just leave your contacts and your question, then we can still answer.
Yeah, we will answer
questions that will pop up later.
Well, thank you for your time.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.